I'm telling you, C2, if they don't shape up, people are gonna go crazy over them. Like, seriously. Oh, hey, hello, my gold viewers. Talking to C2N2 about politics. Now, see him, 4X? He wasn't there last episode. You wanna know why? Because there was a glitch, he didn't load it in, so I had to fix it. So, yeah. Basically, what I did to fix it was, I logged out, then I logged back in, poof, he's there. So, let's go talk to him real quick. O4X, welcome to the team, buddy.
Sir, it is a tremendous pleasure to be here aboard your ship. And mm-hmm. What a ship it is.
Yes, it is.
A BT-7, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep.
One of the pilot designs. A very fine vessel, appropriate for the Republic's best.
Yep.
We will ride this Durasteel Eagle into the heart of the Empire and bring our fight for freedom to the door of the Emperor himself.
I wouldn't go that far, but sure. Welcome to the team.
Make a great addition to Havoc.
I'm proud to know that you feel that way. I have loaded all pertinent data. Let us proceed with our noble duty.
Yep. Ooh, more talking. Yay, more 4X conversations.
Sir, allow me to reiterate my pleasure at serving in your command. Since my verbal brain was first activated, I have longed to engage the enemies of freedom directly. Under your noble leadership, I can finally fulfill the mission the Republic's fearless scientists designed me for.
I'm glad you're happy.
It's good that you're so enthusiastic about our mission.
I can't take all of the credit for my enthusiasm, of course. I owe everything to my primary designer, Dr. Boab Deaton. Thanks to Dr. Deaton, I can understand the importance of our fight and the extent of the threats we face, and I can fight harder for it.
Good to hear.
There's nothing better than fighting for a cause you believe in.
I couldn't agree more, sir.
Every time you talk about the Republic, M14X gets happier. I'm gonna give M14X M14X. I'm gonna give him companion gifts. There we go. I couldn't think for a moment. Oh wait. We're still on Nar Shaddaa. I almost forgot. We're going back to Nar Shaddaa real quick. So that way we can do the side quest for the Deadeyes. A little personal mission for Jorgan. You can get side quests from your companions, so it makes them bond with you more, makes them more of a team than just a group of people. Because a team has to trust each other. A team has to believe in each other and know that they're trustworthy. And to do that is to earn it. Through every single thing you do. Because like all companions, they don't like you until you bring up their likeness about you. Which is not an easy task in SWTOR, because some people hate the exact opposite, like the exact opposite of what your other characters like, which makes it hard. But that's why gifts are a thing. All right, let's go to Belka real quick. I wonder where he is. Move it out. Gonna fly all day. Oh, he's at the promenade.
Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Let's see you guys when we get to the promenade. We have arrived at the promenade. Where is he? At the cantina. Yeah, I'll teleport. It's petty, but it works. If I knew he was going to be in the cantina, I would have teleported there. I noticed I have mail, so I'll check that the first time, next time I see a mailbox. Oh, Jonas! Hey, Jonas! I have something to tell you. Actually, I should have Jorgan for this. It's his quest.
How's that 4X unit treating you? Racking up plenty of kills, I hope.
I haven't used them yet.
Nice. Belker, what do you know?
Let's hear it.
He's right. We didn't come for small talk. Fair enough. I dug up what info I could, but frankly, there isn't much to report. Far as I can tell, the Deadeyes tried to off some Imperial big shot. Things went south, and they got themselves captured.
Is the rescue in the works?
What's the Republic doing to get the Deadeyes back? Unfortunately, nothing. We are on the verge of an incident. The Imperials are out for blood, so the Republic is distancing itself from the operation. I shouldn't even be talking to you about all this. Those boys are on their own.
These are Republic soldiers, sir. Good men. All of them.
We'll find them, Jorgan.
If the Republic won't do anything, then Havoc Squad will. Look, I know this stinks, but my hands are tied on this one. I've got major players breathing down my neck. Otherwise, I tell you to investigate that prison the Imperials set up in Shadowtown.
Finally, some real news.
Now we're getting somewhere. You didn't hear this from me. Now, rumor has it, and I'm just talking here, that the Imperials built themselves a makeshift prison not too far from here. That's where they dump any local riffraff that get out of line. Could be they took the Deadeyes there.
Appreciate the info.
Thanks for the tip, Bulger. I'm just making conversation. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got an alibi to work on. Remember, this meeting never happened.
You knew that one was coming. Just the way how he was talking. Yeah, no. I knew what was coming. Okay, so missing in action. Ah, dang it. I'll see you guys when I get there. Alright, found a mailbox. General Akodomi. I'm told you were responsible for returning Akodomi to the general. You have my serious thanks. I wish to know that he is being cared for by our best healers, not only with those of his body, but his spirit as well. Though he continues to profess he is beyond redemption, I can sense the true Akodomi is not lost to us forever. The atrocities inflicted on him by the Empire can be undone in time. And it's in the, when the world's in the darkest, we must see the light in others. Thank you for having such a clear vision. You're welcome. The way I see it,
are currently open for business.
And I have to go to the industrial sector. All right.
Have a safe and pleasant stay.
The way I see it is that if you show kindness to others, kindness will be shown back later. But to people who have true darkness in their heart, they need to be helped. Now, there are some who deserve the beatings, but there are some who deserve redemption. Now, I'm not the best one to decide who gets what and where, but it's a hard thing to follow. And I'm not the best at following by example, but treat everyone like a brother, a good brother, because if you don't, you're just gonna regret everything you do. Huh. I remember this place all too well. I got my butt beat by a Sith warrior here when I first played. It was my first Sith player encounter. It was not fun. I got real mad real fast. Because he spawn killed me. I waited for him to leave so I can respawn by probe droid. And he showed back up. He was like, ha ha, I'm back. It's just, it was stupid. Borderline on the point of asinine. I don't know if he was just doing it for experience or just fun, but it made me mad. It's those type of moments that you can't forget. I'm not gonna do a heroic. This is probably gonna take more long enough, so. What level are these guys? Level 25s. I can handle 25s, I'm a level 27. I'm a level 28 now! Alright. Okay, my attacks won't do much damage here. And by the way, I've decided once I hit level 30, I'll head to the Republic fleet and show you guys where to get modifications for your armor, for those who want to know. Burn it down. All right. What? Okay, I just went the entirely wrong way. Go figure. I went entirely the wrong way. I guess it just shows that I ain't the best, the playing soldier, because I apparently get lost too easily. Suppression droid, huh? I almost said depression droid. Can you imagine that? A depression droid? Just telling you the things you shouldn't hear on a daily basis. You are all going down! To the ground. And I'll take your money. Bye bye. droids. It's always droids. Why did it have to be droids? For those who don't realize, I just tried to make an Indiana Jones reference about Star Wars. I tried to Star Wars it up. Now, I just want to say that I know I'm not the best player. I'm not the best YouTuber. I'm definitely not the best animator. But I do try. I try my best to make people laugh. I try my best to make everyone happy as best I can. Even though I may screw that up from time to time. I do try. Alright. One console.
They're not on this cell block. Let's move on to the next.
We're still saving the others, right, Jorgan? Oh, come on! There we go. Last one. That took longer than expected. They were tougher. They were tougher. I don't know how, but they were tougher. Other than that, I'm weak because I don't have any augments to my armor. Hit to the face. Blast out. Blast out. Come here. You rascal. Good idea, Jorgan. Oh, come on! There. I'm so bad at being stealthy. Good job, Jorgan.
No sign of them here. Bulker must have sent us on a wild... Wait. I may have something. It's an outgoing holo message. Recent.
This is Captain Titch, confirming the details for outgoing prisoner transfer 993B. We've got 3 Gamorrean trespassers, a couple of spice peddlers, and our catch of the day, the legendary Deadeyes.
At least we know they're alive. Well, yeah. They were at the time of this transmission.
As per protocol, we've split the Deadeyes up and transferred them to off-world labor camps. I've encrypted the coordinates for their designated camps into this transmission. Those scum can spend their remaining years working off their debt.
Ooh.
Message ends there. The imps still make things quick for their POWs. Lucky us.
Grab that data.
Make a copy of those coordinates. On it. The encryption here is good. Too good. I can't crack it. Looks like we may need Balker's services again.
At least I know where he is this time. Slippery Slopes Cantina. good to know where people are. That way, if you need them again, you can find them. Interrupting?
Is this a bad time? On the contrary. Now I know exactly where to stick my foot. Senior Agent Zane, SIS. That little stunt you pulled ruined any chance we had of negotiating the Deadeye's safe return.
Check your facts, Zane. The Imperials already shipped them off world.
It's Senior Agent Zane, thank you. And storming an Imperial facility, guns blazing, it makes things worse. Your involvement ends now. Clear.
Our comrades come first.
Our involvement ends when the Deadeyes are free.
Then you can tell your CO to expect a little love note from me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got an Imperial ambassador to mollify. I trust you'll see yourselves off my planet.
Your planet?
What were you thinking coming back here? I told you I couldn't be connected to any of this.
We found some encrypted coordinates in the prison central computer. We think they'll tell us where the Deadeyes are.
Can you help us?
Any chance you can decrypt those coordinates for us?
Not with Zane watching me.
Look, a friend in Signal Intelligence owes me a favor. I'll put you in contact with him. He may be able to make something of those coordinates. It's the best I can do.
Thank the next man, Jorgan.
You couldn't have done this without Balker. I think you owe him your thanks.
Fine. Balker. Thanks.
Hey, anything for you, Jorgan.
I'll connect with Malka's contact once we get back to the ship. I'll report if I hear anything.
Alright. So now we wait. We wait for Jorgan to get to have
on your feet.
To get the information. Just checking if the recording software is still going. Cause there are times it doesn't work. But okay, so those were Imperial players. Luckily for the promenade, this is a safe area. No enemies fighting, nothing. See? There's another one. Sith Assassin. Funny, you can always tell when someone's an Imperial player by how their companions look. Now I head back to the ship and I go to the Shadow Fist. So I'll see you guys there. Okay everyone, we are arriving at the Shadow Fist, Tavis's ship. Most likely we need to talk to Garza first. Huh. Go figure. We're not talking to Garza first. Well, let's go blow this place up. I'm taking M14X with me since he's the lowest one in the companion list at the moment. You could use some of it. And if it doesn't work, I'll switch. If none of the conversation things work, I'll switch to Alara, because I want to try getting a romance with her. It's always because she seems more capable. Oi. Ooh.
Deadeyes stand by for examination and suggested products.
All right.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
I am fit for duty. Return to my post. Blech. Oh no, suicide drone. Suicide drone. Four levels above you, so I have a level one weapon. How sad is that? Where's that droid eye? Why'd I get that? Alright. I'm ultra focused right now. Don't get burned. Ha! No, 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 no. Okay. Suicide drones. Ah. I'm just gonna... Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Wow. So if one shows up, all of them show up. Go figure. Dang it, 4X. Man, it is good thing I have him as a healer. Now, 4X, I know you can't help it, but stay out of the flames. There. All right. Oh. I can realign them to how I want. Huh. Go figure.
It's good to see you again, Lieutenant. It is Lieutenant now, right? You're doing so well for
Tavis.
Yourself. I'm very
Travis.
Proud. I have to thank you for working this little meeting into your very busy schedule. It took me some trouble to arrange.
Give yourself up.
In the name of the Republic, I order you to surrender.
You know, you're so threatening over Holdo that I might even consider it. Let me get back to you later. You have caused me a great deal of difficulty, Lieutenant. Some have even called you my nemesis. Was that your goal?
I'm just doing my duty.
My goal is to bring traitors to justice.
So is mine, Lieutenant. Needles, even Captain Andrick. What is wrong with you? They were heroes, Lieutenant.
I enjoyed killing them, Tavis. And I'm going to enjoy killing you.
No, that doesn't sound right. That sounds sadistic.
It's good after.
In the name of the
Republic. You know,
my goal is to bring traitors.
So, Needles, they were heroes.
Your squad mates betrayed the Republic, just like you.
You're a fool. In my entire career, only one other enemy has been as difficult as you. The Imperial Shadow Fist. One of the most elite commando units in all of the Sith Empire.
Hmm.
Five of the Emperor's deadliest agents.
Surrender, Travis.
Please, end this before anyone else has to die.
I have only just begun, Lieutenant. Havoc Squad and the Shadow Fist fought many times. We battled to a standstill over and over again. We were the worst of enemies. But times have changed, Lieutenant. Meet my five newest friends.
Havoc Squad, defensive positions.
Slaughter protocols activated.
You're overdue for a painful death, Lieutenant. Goodbye.
You're not gonna survive. I told you. Okay, the commander, huh? Whoa! Porak's gone behind the wall.
Oh!
Ooh, I can sell that. We did it, people. More suicide drones. Let me guess, can't leave till they're gone, right? Ha! I escaped the suicide drones, ha 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 ha. Well, the shuttle is now just an empty ship full of corpses and robot parts. Booyah! I love that. The old Havoc squad couldn't handle them.
Lieutenant, report. Were you able to neutralize Tavis?
It was all set up.
No Tavis, just the Shadow Fist.
Incredible. Ambushed by the Empire's best and still standing. You retrieved a military asset of incredible importance in the face of extreme danger. You did well.
Thank you.
Our only choice now is to proceed as originally planned. Our technicians have determined your final two target locations, Tatooine and Alderaan. I'll give you a full briefing when you arrive at each mission zone. Move out immediately.
All right.
Garza out.
Do I get to talk with any of my companions? Yes, I do. One is Lara Dorne. And 1-4-X.
If I may say so, sir, you've had quite an impressive career. You're the commander of the most elite squad in the entire Republic. You must be quite proud.
Yes, I am very
Serving
proud.
An Havoc squad has been the greatest honor of my career.
I remember when I first enlisted and qualified for medical specialization. My brother Alexei completed his technical specialization on the same day. We were both proud to finally serve in the Imperial military. My brother advanced quickly, but I became disillusioned as time went on.
What changed your mind?
Why did you become disillusioned?
The Imperial military was supposed to stand for honor and discipline. But my superiors discarded those concepts any time a Sith asked it. I'd always been taught that the Jedi and the Republic were genocidal hypocrites. But the only brutalities I witnessed were committed by my own comrades.
What'd you do?
Did you try to change things or did you defect right away?
I raised my concerns with my superiors, but they only questioned my resolve. Soon, I would have been forced to prove my loyalty by carrying out orders directly against my conscience. I chose to defect instead.
Sounds wise.
You'd say you made the right move, Dorne.
Once I'd made the decision, I slipped away during my squad's next night patrol. I was gone before anyone realized it. I surrendered to the first Republic patrol I came across and declared my intention to defect. That was over 3 years ago. It's strange to realize how long it's been. The Republic truly feels like my home now.
Glad to hear it, Dorne. Glad to hear it. Now let's talk to 4X.
It is an amazing thing to know that you are exceptional, sir. I'm sure you know the feeling, given your incredible service record. My programming, my weaponry, my armor, all state of the art, and my power core. A true marvel. Other droids may look like me or have some of my capabilities, but none of them have my power core. I'm very proud to be so unique.
Individuality is important.
Well, the differences among us are what give the Republic its strength.
Exactly, sir. Billions of unique individuals coming together to contribute to the greater good. Oh, it's truly inspiring. I see Havoc Squad in much the same way. We are set apart from other infantry teams by one thing. You. Thanks to your wise and courageous leadership, Havoc Squad is the finest military unit in the Republic. You are what makes Havoc special.
Thank you very much.
It's very kind of you to say that, 4X.
By analyzing our unit's strengths, we can better utilize them against our depraved enemies. Let's return to the fight, sir. It's already been too long since I saw Imperial soldiers stomped into the muck where they belong.
Ooh, another thing for 4X.
Sir, if you have a moment, I've developed an initiative to improve morale amongst our fellow soldiers. As we both know, Havoc Squad is the finest military team ever assembled.
Okay.
Our triumphs prove to the public that victory is near. Unfortunately, as a team, even we can only accomplish so many victories in a given amount of time. Therefore, I would like to undertake additional assignments on my own time.
What do you have in mind, 4X?
What kind of additional assignments?
I'd like to coordinate with Command and the SIS to find extra targets. Imperial personnel no one else could challenge, and neutralize them.
That's a great idea.
So tough winds would really get our troops fired up.
My calculations suggest the Republic's forces' morale would increase more than 18% for each impossible target I neutralize. Such incredible victories would demoralize the putrid citizens of the Empire as much as they would encourage our heroic comrades.
That's true. I agree.
It's a good plan, 4X. Make it happen.
I'll inform you as soon as I locate a suitable target, sir.
Okay. Next episode, we'll be going to... Let's see. What level do I have to be for Alderaan? 28 to 32. In Tatooine, 24 to 28. I'll be doing this one because it's lower level and I can do more. So next episode, we'll be going to Tatooine. See you guys there, and goodbye.